Imagine waking up every morning for a month and adding an extra pinch of salt to everything you eat, your eggs, your pasta, even your salad. At first, it feels harmless. Salt makes everything taste better, right? But beneath that flavor boost, something invisible begins. Your body, finely tuned to maintain perfect chemical balance, starts to fight back against an unexpected overload. The first days don't feel strange. You might even feel more alive as your taste buds light up. But the truth is, your body is already adapting, working overtime to keep your sodium levels steady. Your kidneys, those silent filters beneath your ribs, are the first to notice. They begin pushing harder, trying to flush out the excess before it causes chaos. But here's the twist. What if they can't keep up? What if day by day, the balance slips just enough to start a silent chain reaction? Over the next few minutes, you'll see what 30 days of salt can do to the organs that keep you alive. Because while salt keeps food from spoiling, it might just be slowly doing the same to you. Our bodies are wired to crave salt. Thousands of years ago, salt meant survival. It preserved food and kept us hydrated in the heat. But evolution never planned for the modern diet, where salt hides in everything from bread to cereal. It's everywhere, quietly building up. The brain still rewards every salty bite with dopamine, a surge of pleasure that tells you this is good, you need this. It's an ancient trick of biology that no longer serves us. That's why it's easy to go from enjoying salt to depending on it without even realizing it. What most people don't know is that your kidneys are constantly balancing this love affair. Every grain of salt you eat demands water to keep your bloodstream stable. The more sodium you take in, the more your kidneys need to work, and the harder they struggle to keep you safe. In the background, tiny capillaries inside those organs are starting to strain. You can't feel it yet, but the damage has already begun. On the first day, nothing dramatic happens, but inside your body, a subtle shift starts. Sodium attracts water, and your body begins holding on to extra fluid. That means your heart has to pump harder, your vessels expand slightly, and your kidneys, those natural filters, are working overtime. It's as if you've turned up the pressure on a water hose. Everything seems fine at first, but constant pressure begins to wear out the system. By the third or fourth day, you might notice puffiness in your face or hands. You might feel thirstier than usual, but ignore it, thinking it's nothing. Your brain doesn't warn you because it's used to quick changes. It doesn't see the danger in slow ones. And so the retention continues, silently. Your urine becomes slightly more concentrated, a clue most people never notice. That's the thing about salt. It doesn't hurt fast. It hurts quietly. Around day 5, your body begins to complain. You start feeling unusually thirsty, like no amount of water satisfies you. That's your brain's way of saying, "We're drowning in salt." The pituitary gland releases hormones that try to regulate fluid levels, but your kidneys are already feeling the strain. It's a biochemical tug of war. Sodium trying to hold on to water, hormones begging to let it go. The longer this goes on, the more confused your system becomes. Blood pressure creeps upward, but you won't notice. Maybe you'll blame it on stress or lack of sleep. The irony is that your body is trying to protect you, using every mechanism it has, but the flood of salt is relentless. The harder your kidneys push, the more they tire. And this is just the beginning. The real storm hasn't even started yet. Under a microscope, your kidneys look like vast forests of tiny tubes. Each one filters your blood hundreds of times a day. But when salt levels spike, those filters begin to swell. The delicate balance between sodium and potassium shifts, forcing the kidneys to retain even more fluid. As pressure rises, the glomeruli, those microscopic filters start showing signs of stress. The arteries that feed them narrow slightly, forcing your heart to work harder to push blood through. You won't feel pain, but your body is entering a phase of quiet resistance. Over time, this creates micro damage, tiny scars that can build up over years. In just a few days of salt overload, you're setting the stage for something your future self will regret. It's a silent war between flavor and function, and the flavor is winning. Have you ever noticed how your body reacts when you eat too much salty food? Maybe swollen fingers, headaches, or that constant thirst? Tell me in the comments. I want to know if you've ever felt your body fighting back like this. By day 6 or 7, your arteries begin to feel the impact of the extra salt. Sodium draws water into your bloodstream, increasing the total volume of fluid that your heart must pump. Imagine turning a garden hose to full blast. The pressure rises and the walls of the hose begin to strain. That's exactly what happens inside your arteries. Your blood pressure starts climbing, slowly and silently, with each extra pinch of salt you consume. Your heart senses the change immediately. It starts beating with more force, trying to overcome the resistance. The cells lining your arteries, called endothelial cells, become irritated by the constant tension. They begin to produce less nitric oxide, the molecule that keeps blood vessels relaxed and flexible. Without it, your vessels stiffen, and the cycle worsens. Over time, this added pressure doesn't just stay in your heart or arteries, it bounces back to your kidneys. They're flooded with blood they can't properly filter, forced to handle both excess volume and excess sodium at once. The result is stress, microscopic damage, and inflammation. The body adapts the best it can, but every adaptation has a cost. Each day of salt overload adds another invisible layer of strain to a system that's meant to last a lifetime. Ironically, during the first 2 weeks of eating too much salt, many people feel better, more alert, more awake, more alive. That's because salt triggers a mild increase in adrenaline and cortisol, stress hormones that make you feel energized. Your brain interprets the higher blood pressure and increased circulation as vitality, a trick of chemistry that masks the early damage. Have you ever noticed how your body reacts when you eat too much salty food? Maybe swollen fingers, headaches, or that constant thirst? Tell me in the comments. I want to know if you've ever felt your body fighting back like this.
But that burst of vitality is borrowed energy. Behind the scenes, your cells are exhausting themselves, trying to stay hydrated. When this temporary boost fades, fatigue sets in. Your kidneys and adrenal glands are working harder than ever to stabilize you, and that energy cost adds up. So while salt might make your fries taste better, the illusion of feeling fine is one of the cruelest tricks your body can play on you. By the second week, your body is locked in a cellular battle it can't win easily. Every cell in your body is surrounded by fluid, and that balance depends on precise sodium levels. When salt intake rises, sodium pulls water out of cells into the bloodstream, leaving those cells slightly dehydrated. You might not notice it, but your skin, muscles, and even your brain start to feel the effects. Inside the kidneys, this imbalance becomes a war zone. The nephrons, microscopic units that filter blood, are forced to reabsorb and release sodium constantly. It's a process that burns energy and releases free radicals, unstable molecules that damage cell walls over time. That oxidative stress builds silently, contributing to kidney aging long before you ever feel symptoms. Meanwhile, your immune system is quietly responding to the damage. Inflammation increases, not just in your kidneys, but throughout your body. The blood becomes thicker, more viscous, as your fluid balance skews toward sodium dominance. Salt doesn't just affect your taste buds, it shifts the entire chemistry of life within you. And the longer you keep it up, the more chaos it creates beneath the surface. By the 15th day, your kidneys are exhausted. Each nephron has been filtering blood under increased pressure for 2 weeks straight. The tiny vessels feeding them have started to narrow, a protective reflex that unfortunately makes things worse. The kidneys receive less oxygen, less blood flow, and their ability to remove waste begins to falter. You might feel fine, no pain, no alarm bells, but inside, microscopic scarring is forming. This is called glomerulosclerosis, a condition where kidney filters harden and lose function over time. It starts quietly and ends in chronic kidney disease if the cycle continues for years. Your body tries to adapt by producing more renin and angiotensin, hormones that tighten blood vessels and raise blood pressure even higher. It's a desperate measure, a survival mechanism gone wrong. The more the kidneys struggle, the more they trigger the very pressure that's killing them. And still, you feel normal. That's what makes this so dangerous. The deadliest damage is the kind you never feel coming. By the third week, something new can begin to form. Crystals. As your urine becomes more concentrated from the constant sodium overload, calcium and uric acid begin to clump together inside the kidneys. They're microscopic at first, invisible to scans, painless to the touch, but they're the beginning of what we call kidney stones. Most people associate kidney stones with unbearable pain, but that only comes later, when those crystals grow large enough to move. In the early stages, they're harmless, floating quietly inside the kidney's ducts. Yet each day of high salt intake feeds them, binding more minerals to their surface until they become solid, jagged stones. Inside the kidney tissue, these growing particles scratch the delicate lining, causing tiny inflammations. The body tries to repair the damage, but the process creates scar tissue, making future stones even more likely. It's a cycle that can take years to manifest, but it begins right here, with just a little too much salt.
The most frightening part? You can't feel it. You might think you're fine, but your kidneys are quietly filling with time bombs. By now, your kidneys aren't the only organs feeling the strain. Your brain is joining the battle. High salt intake doesn't just affect the body's chemistry, it changes how your brain perceives hunger and satisfaction. Elevated sodium levels interfere with the hypothalamus, the region that controls thirst, appetite, and energy regulation. The result? You crave more. More food, more salt, more flavor. This craving isn't hunger in the traditional sense. It's chemical confusion. Your brain misinterprets the signals from your body, believing you need more energy, when in reality, you need balance. Studies have shown that salt can activate the same reward pathways as sugar and even certain addictive substances. The more you eat, the more you want, and the harder it becomes to stop. At the same time, this excess salt increases cortisol production, the stress hormone. You might notice small changes, irritability, brain fog, or fatigue. That's not just coincidence. It's your nervous system reacting to chemical imbalance. And while you reach for another salty snack, your kidneys sigh in exhaustion, silently wishing you'd listen to the signals your body is sending. Let's imagine you decide to stop. No salt, no processed food, no fast meals. Sounds healthy, right? But the first few days after a high-salt diet can feel surprisingly rough. Your body has adapted to the overload, and suddenly it's forced to readjust. The result is the salt rebound. In this phase, your kidneys release excess water and sodium rapidly, leading to frequent urination, headaches, and fatigue. Your blood pressure drops faster than your body can handle, leaving you dizzy or weak. It's not danger, it's detox. Your system is recalibrating, learning to find equilibrium again. Interestingly, this rebound can reveal just how dependent you've become on salt. food tastes bland, energy levels fluctuate, and your brain demands what it's missing, the dopamine rush of sodium. But within a week, balance begins to return. Blood pressure stabilizes, the kidneys start to heal, and your cells rehydrate properly. What was once a storm inside your body slowly clears. It's like opening a window after years in a smoky room. Your system finally breathes again. The kidneys are among the most resilient organs in the human body. They filter around 50 gallons of blood every day and can continue functioning if only half their tissue is healthy. But, like any machine, repeated stress leaves scars. So, can your kidneys truly recover after a month of salt overload? The answer is partially. When you lower your sodium intake, the blood vessels relax. The microdamage inside your kidneys can heal if it hasn't advanced too far. The swelling in the nephrons reduces, the oxidative stress calms, and filtration improves. In some studies, kidney function has been shown to rebound significantly after just a few weeks of balanced diet and hydration. However, scar tissue never fully disappears. Once a nephron is damaged beyond repair, it doesn't regenerate. The kidneys compensate by working harder with the remaining ones, but that extra effort has a price. So yes, your kidneys can heal, but they never forget. Every grain of salt you eat becomes part of that memory. Across the world, a few brave or unlucky individuals have tried the 30-day salt experiment, intentionally or not. Some did it for science, others without realizing it, living on processed foods packed with hidden sodium. In every case, the body reacted the same: rising blood pressure, swelling, fatigue, and eventually, an overwhelming thirst. In one study, volunteers increased their salt intake by just 1 teaspoon per day. Within 2 weeks, their blood pressure spiked dramatically and their kidneys began showing signs of reduced filtration efficiency. The participants reported constant thirst, poor sleep, and strange cravings. But the most shocking part? All of these effects appeared long before they felt sick. When they returned to a normal diet, recovery was possible, but it took time. Some people's blood pressure remained high for weeks, proof that the body remembers the imbalance even after the experiment ends. Because what happens to your kidneys with salt overload isn't so different from what happens when you simply don't drink enough water. If you're curious about that, check out What Happens If You Don't Drink Water for 7 Days, Science Explained. It's one of the most eye-opening experiments we've ever broken down. Because what happens to your kidneys with salt overload isn't so different from what happens when you simply don't drink enough water. Here's the truth scientists agree on. The human body needs less than 1 teaspoon of salt per day to function properly. But most people consume double or triple that amount without realizing it. Over time, that excess doesn't just affect your taste buds, it shapes your health, your energy, even your lifespan. After 30 days of high salt intake, your body has adapted to survive, but not to thrive. The kidneys work harder, your heart pumps faster, your arteries stiffen, and your brain still whispers, "More, please." It's a loop of addiction wrapped in flavor. The good news is, every healthy choice you make helps your body fight back. Reducing processed food, staying hydrated, and moving daily gives your kidneys the relief they've been craving. Within weeks, blood pressure can drop, and your cells begin to restore balance. Salt gives life flavor, but too much of it takes life away, one silent grain at a time. If you learned something new today, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe for more Science Explained health stories, and share this video with someone who might need a little reminder to go easy on the salt.